Let me describe what I'm sick of as far as political discussion online, and some of the reason why the frequency in my making videos has changed so much, and why it's likely that the nature of a lot of my videos is going to change as well. The discussions go like this. You're not willing to reject conservatism, or Republicans, or barely anything about conservatism, over what the people who have the most power are doing, or what they believe and why they believe what they believe, especially the religious moralists who have a lot of power. Yet I'm supposed to reject liberalism and even the Democratic Party over what college students are doing and saying and what Antifa people are doing and saying. What is there to discuss at that point? Most of the time, I would usually just give up and start going on about how terrible college students and Antifa are. I did the right job for them. I was a stooge for Republicans, and I regret it. Should I listen to you reply, but I'm a conservative, and I'm not that way? Well, congratulations. Do you want your own special letterhead, or do you want a medal or something? Do you have power in the U.S. government? Then for someone like me who lives in the U.S., why does that matter? Are you saying that the power someone has isn't supposed to matter under principle? So now I should discuss principles that don't amount to a hill of beans as far as how they get implemented? I shouldn't care about what people in power are doing and promoting? I should look at the true principles and examples of people who have no power? Sorry, it doesn't work that way. It's a useless conversation, honestly. The only politics that actually matter are the politics of people who have power. I mean, what good does discussing any of this shit do? Oh, well, these are the real principles. Yeah, what good does any of that do? It doesn't do anything. It's just a waste of time. It's a waste of energy. It's a waste of emotion. It's a waste. So when you come at me with, but I'm a conservative and I'm not that way, I just want to give up on the conversation. Any little bit that I give after you say that you're not that way, and you'll start ratcheting it up, until eventually I'll be saying negative things about the left on a ratio of 10 to 1. And then I'm supposed to consider that being more balanced, or being more of a centrist, or that it's somehow being more realistic. No, fuck you. I'm not playing that game anymore. College students don't have power. And if they actually try to take over the Democratic Party, the party will just lose. And another party will emerge. That's just how it is. Is it taking over Hollywood and legacy media? With the exception of cinematic blockbuster amusement park rides that do make a lot of money, Hollywood is failing and legacy media is on its way out. So who fucking cares? Are you really that concerned over whether your cinematic amusement park ride is promoting an ideology? Is that some form of oppression? But my comic book character isn't being put on the screen the way that I'd like. Oh, so let's get out the pitchforks then, right? Why not go on a real amusement park ride instead if all you really care about in cinematic entertainment is being amused? You can't beat a good roller coaster for something like that. I mean, if you want your comics to remain like comics, then go read a comic. If you don't like new comics, then read old comics. Just like if you don't like new music, listen to old music. But stop complaining that the entertainment world isn't doing what you want. Do you know how many videos I could make going on about what I think is wrong with modern pop music? On a more positive note, I could make a bunch of videos going on about why I think 1967 to 1987 was the best period for pop music. Another thing I get sick of is this notion that, oh, mainstream media, all they care about is making you angry so they can make money. You should look at independent media more. Yet, right-tilting media and media that poses as independent media, they do nothing but try to make people angry. And it does a better job at making people angry because its audience is somehow convinced that it's not just all about making money and being popular. Now, granted, there are examples of people who claim they're independent media who are just really angry people and they want to spread that anger because, well, misery loves company, or because it's cathartic in some way. So somehow I should have respect for people who do this as long as it's done with an independent spirit. Why not reject all the crap that's designed to make people angry? Then there are the people who try to claim that 9/11 was an inside job and most of these shootings are psyops, and some of them might even try to claim that I'm doing the work of COINTELPRO, who tell me that I'm depressed and sad and angry solely because of what mainstream media pushes out. And I should pay attention to all those indie media sites that try to say, oh, this is the real news, who all that these sites do, or channels do, is promote conspiracy theories everywhere. They see conspiracies in everything. And that somehow, in my focusing on that, it would make me not depressed. Whatever, it's laughable. Why would I waste my time with something that unproductive and frustrating on any of it? It's all a bunch of crap. I have more productive and more enjoyable things to focus on. We have just one life. Why make it something of anger? Just saying.